My name is Jim Studnicki. I'm the founder and president of Creekside Digital. I originally started the company because I was interested in researching some microfilm from a unit that fought in the American Civil War. I found a company to get the rolls digitized for me. So I learned two things. They charged me a lot of money to do that, and they did a really lousy job. 80 to 90% of our work is digitization of cultural heritage materials for libraries and archives. We have been able to grow our business by focusing on very, very high-end digitization. We're using the Phase One IQ180, 80 megapixel digital back. We also have the Digital Transitions RCam. It's specifically made for copy work and folks in the cultural heritage community that are digitizing these types of projects on a daily basis, where we need to have a completely locked down, rigid camera system that is not going to move on us. Now we've got this in the digital format, we can do all kinds of cool stuff with it. It can be loaded into a database, we can capture all sorts of metadata that describes that item, and that really unlocks the true value to the researcher, to the end user. In terms of a competitive advantage, it's the speed and the quality. We have the control over every aspect of everything that we need to, from the optics to the lighting. It allows us to shoot everything from multiple types of photographic materials, non-microfilm transmissive materials, reflective photographic prints, art reproduction, of course, we can do that as well, and then manuscripts. All those sorts of things become possible when you have a real camera versus just a fixed scanning platform. Having a partner like Digital Transitions is critical for us. When you do mass digitization, something is always going to go not as it exactly should. And we need to know that the folks that we bought it from, when something goes wrong, I can pick up the phone and get help when we need it. One of the coolest parts about my job is that I get to work with all these amazing historical projects, something that might have happened 50 or 100 or 200 years ago in this country. And then, there's a direct reference to something that, some current event that might be happening today. We really can assist in shining the light on what happened in the past and share it with other people. That's really cool.